my objective today is to present this, first of all, by creating a protocol on the OneLab software, and then really putting that protocol in place, as you will be able to see here in front of the robot, and literally executing live that protocol with you guys today. So thanks for joining. Maybe starting off on the first point, what is this? It's a liquid handling robot. The robot can fully automate the use of these pipettes by using also the domino bench space that it has in front of them. And I will just touch upon that a little bit later on. So first things first, let's talk about the cloud software. And here's where we create the protocols for the Andrew robots that will then be executed by the robot, of course. So start with a home page here where I can have a list of all the protocols that I've previously designed. And what I will want to show you here in a few minutes is designing a new protocol and how simple that is to do. So let's start by the very beginning here. On the screen that I've got, I have a virtual bench space on which I create my protocol by simply dragging and dropping to create consumables and also pipetting steps. So let me show you that in a brief. Here I can go into the list of all the consumables that we have in our OneLab software. So let's keep it simple for now and add a couple tubes. So here I've just added a microtube into my list of consumables that I want to work with and add these to my bench. The software will now zoom in on those consumables and allow me to start working with them and create a protocol from start to finish. And what I will of course start by doing is here selecting one of those consumables and adding solution or adding some kind of buffer or sample that I would like to start working with. So just clicking on that consumable there and clicking on add right here. What I see next is a list of all of the solutions that I've pre-created, of course, but I can always add a new one if I'd like. So let's just make that this is some buffer that I'd like to dispense from one tube to the next. So you'll probably see where I'm going with this. I want to create a simple pipetting step with a drag and drop motion. So what I'm going to do is here select the pipetting mode on the upper left of our software and simply drag and drop from one source tube to the destination tube in order to be able to create a pipetting step. So naturally, what you're seeing on the screen here is what comes up next. All of the parameters that are associated with that pipetting step. So this is volume, different mixing, whether that's changing tips or not changing tips, the speed of aspiration. All of these parameters are associated in this step right here, and I simply need to select which ones I'd like for that pipetting step. So let's keep this example simple and simply say 100 microliters or 10 microliters into that microtube that I've selected. So I've just typed in 10 here and I can save that step. The protocol in OneLab automatically zooms into this and tells us that we have one step that has been defined in the protocol as being that 10 microliter transfer. All good so far. Now, this is simply a pipetting step, but the OneLab software allows us to do much more than that. It is a universal protocol design software, so we can do this pipetting step, but also include many other lab actions, centrifugation, magnetic fields, weighting, incubation, heating, shaking, cooling, all of this can also be integrated within our protocol. So now, this was just a quick example, so I'll go back to my projects page in which I've created an example protocol to run with you live today. And this is just a simple dilution in a well plate using multi-channel pipettes. So I'm going to execute this protocol here now. And you'll notice that OneLab will suggest different ways of automating that protocol or different ways of executing that protocol. So what we see in the list here is, of course, a manual option for executing that protocol, but also the Andrew Plus that I have here connected right next to me as an option for being able to execute that and which pipettes I will need to do that. So let's select here now this Andrew robot that I'd like to use. Have a quick look at the material list of everything that I will need ready in order to be able to run and execute this protocol on the Andrew Plus. And this next window here that you'll see is the bench preparation window that will really allow the user to create, to be the interface between the protocol that was written on OneLab and actually executing it on the robot itself. So you'll notice a parallel here between the image we're seeing on the left and the different positions and what I need to, as a user, put into place. So these individual blocks are what we call dominoes. They create the interface between the consumable So any standard labware that you have in the lab, and the robot that will be using a camera to scan these QR codes and know exactly where those consumables are in the bench space in front of him. So to be entirely clear, these are what we call dominoes. They're magnetic. They attract to one another to the base plate of the robot and essentially allow us as operators to have a very flexible and compact bench space depending on the protocols that we want to launch. So with a compact bench space can be as little as 2 or 3 or 4 dominoes, but can go up to 11 dominoes if we'd like. It can also be fit under most standard laminar flow hoods because of that flexibility depending on the protocol that we want to launch. So that's the concept of dominoes. And now I'm going to basically be live running through it now, putting these in place, making sure that they're right before starting this protocol. So in position 1, we'll notice that we need this box of tips right here. So a 1.2 ml box of tips in position 1. So this is what I've done. The software is telling me to have enough in order to be able to execute this protocol. Here they are. Position 2, go right here. And I notice that I'll need at least 17 orange, so 300 microliter tips. And these are all color coded depending on the volume range that we'd like to have in position 2. So I've made sure that this domino is right in position 2. And so on and so forth. And you'll notice here on the screen that there are actually 2 red dominoes, which means that we as users need to validate the starting volume that the robot's going to be working with. This allows the robot to know which and how to follow the liquid level that's inside. So here we notice a red block here saying that in position A1, I need a certain amount of volume in that microtube right there for the robot to be able to execute. So I'm going to actually have a look before. Notice that right here in this tube in position A1, I have 500 microliters that are ready to go. So as a user, I will go manually insert this volume range here. 500. Check that the labware volume has been checked and move on from there. In the reservoir, I have done the same, made sure that there's enough volume. Check that volume there. And now you'll notice that there's a green button at the top right here that allows me to simply start the experiment. So the robot is now in the bench space in order to validate that me as a user have placed these dominoes and provided the correct information to the software before the robot starts. So he's now validating my every move essentially. By using that camera that I mentioned before to scan the QR codes of the different dominoes on the bench space in front of it. So that allows him to identify if the dominoes are there and whether they're in the correct position. So he will do this for a few minutes, and this now allows me to essentially describe a little bit further what I had described at the beginning of my presentation here regarding the pipettes. So these pipettes are manufactured by Sartorius. And what they have as a difference between the PICUS, acclaimed PICUS range of pipettes, is that they have a Bluetooth connectivity chip. This Bluetooth connectivity chip allows all of the parameters that I've just set in the OneLab software to be immediately sent through the robot and to the pipettes. So the robot has now scanned the full bench and validated that I have indeed put the right dominoes in the right spot. And so he's now ready to move on and start using these pipettes. So you'll notice here that the robot has magnetically bound to one of these 8-channel pipettes, which brings me to mention one other quick feature of the Andrew Plus robot, and that is its ability to work with both single and multi-channel pipettes. So for a volume range covering 0.2 microliters all the way to 10 milliliters, depending on the pipettes that we place on the tool rack of the Andrew Plus robot. So here I have 4 available positions. And I have decided for this protocol that I need to use these, so both single channel and multi-channel pipettes. So that's essentially putting in place the robot for the launch and execution of a simple pipetting protocol.